leaves us in the dark.
And we got Zach Lupica. We got Brett Haber. Great research team going on. Meantime, over in Istanbul, Gina Bouchard has never beaten Svetlana Kuznetsova. This was a wild match, Tracy.
It really was. It was Bouchard who had the 5-4 lead, serving for it. But Kuznetsova is an incredible fighter, and she gets the break back, pushes it to 5-all, which eventually goes to the tiebreak. And look at the anticipation from Bouchard. Excellent. She's moving so well. She spent a lot of time, Bouchard, in Vegas working with Gil Reyes. She's gotten much stronger. And big serve. She's been serving well, nice to her spots, good locations. And then it's the second set, and Bouchard has one of her match points, but it's the big forehand, the massive forehand from the Russian that saves one of the three that Bouchard had in the second set. And unfortunate double fault, we go to three. And so how is Bouchard going to regroup mentally? It's so difficult oftentimes when you've had those match points and you let them go, but she does a great job of just compartmentalizing that third set, showing again how well she's hitting so close to the lines. Serve is back. And you know what? I got to say, it's been a tough grind for the last couple of years for Jeannie Bouchard, and I'm really proud of her. The way that she put her head down and worked hard, it's coming through.
Absolutely. Some other scores from Istanbul. Herzog getting a win. Rebecca Peterson, that retirement from Gasparian with the knee injury, had to withdraw from the tournament. And Alison Van Oudvank, the sixth seed, is out. But for Jeannie Bouchard, best win since October of 2018, Paul. She qualified and takes out the top seed in Svetlana Kuznetsova. Tracy mentioned it. How about the mindset for Jeannie? Because she has talked about the fact she wasn't ranked high enough to play in the bubble, Western and Southern Open, U.S. Open. She's like, I'm going to play challengers. I'm going to go to Europe early. And I'm going to go in qualifying to try to get my ranking back up.
Well, today was pretty amazing, right, Tracy? You said it, after losing those match points, for someone that's kind of floundering a little bit with confidence, to lose match points in the second set and then turn it around at the beginning of the third and have a really big third set, that's really impressive. I wanted to ask you, Tracy, how much do you think her playing team tennis helped
getting extra matches? That's a great point. I mean, first it was Charleston, so she got plenty of matches there, singles and doubles. And then team tennis is a short set and it's no ad scoring, so you really have to focus and you're dealing with the pressure. I think Jeannie played like 17 doubles matches, five or six singles matches. So that accumulates. But I think it's the mindset. I really do. I mean, this is, Jeannie Bouchard was former top five in the world, Wimbledon finalist, semifinalist at the French Open. It's hard to kind of swallow your pride. You're 372 when the shutdown opens up. You just got to go over to Prague, which she did. She actually went twice. She came back, worked out in Las Vegas in between. She's over there with wild card. She's playing qualifying. That's hard to do, and she's getting her game back. It's fun to see.
Yep. Absolutely. And now just one win away from returning inside the top 200.